Hello from the Bureau as heavy rain continues along the eastern seaboard with more on the way over the weekend. The flood risk is evolving, particularly through New South Wales east of the Divide, where we're looking at the potential for flash flooding, overland flooding and river rises. This includes in areas currently impacted by fires. By the time the rain ends, many coastal areas of northern New South Wales will have seen their highest rainfall total since March 2017, and for others in southern New South Wales since June 2016. In the 24 hours to 9 a.m. Friday, between 100 and 200 millimetres fell all the way from the Sunshine Coast down towards the mid-north coast of New South Wales, with the highest totals focused between around the Gold Coast and Coffs Harbour, including 283 millimetres at Byron Bay, 231 millimetres at Ballingen and 200 millimetres at Evans Head. Even Manly on Sydney's North Shore picked up 104 millimetres. Minor flood warnings are current for the Noosa River in Queensland, as well as the Ballinger and Kallang Rivers and Orara Rivers in New South Wales. With more rain on the way, flood watches remain in place for most coastal catchments from southeast Queensland down to southern New South Wales. It's possible that flooding will reach moderate to major levels in the Hawkesbury-Nepean catchment and parts of the south coast. The low pressure trough continues to deepen near the New South Wales coast, feeding on warm, moist air from the Tasman Sea. An upper trough over southeast Australia is reinforcing the weather system, helping to draw in that humid, moist northeasterly airflow. All the ingredients are there for continued prolonged rain, heavy showers and thunderstorms throughout the weekend, and a severe weather warning is in force for eastern New South Wales. Damaging winds are possible between around Gosford and Coffs Harbour today, shifting further south along the coast in the warning area during tonight. Damaging surf may develop during Saturday afternoon, leading to beach erosion, and abnormally high tides will bring the risk of coastal inundation to some areas, particularly in the mornings. Latest computer model forecasts show the trough strengthening into the weekend, and there's a chance we could even see an east coast low develop along the trough. Rainfall will intensify and become more widespread, and particularly it will build towards the south. For our fire grounds, where the landscape is so vulnerable right now, this means the risk of falling trees and landslides, and large volumes of runoff containing debris, including ash, soil, trees and rocks. Along the central and south coasts, we're looking at rainfall totals well in excess of 100 millimetres, potentially into the hundreds of millimetres over the course of the weekend. It's hard to imagine fires still burning along the south coast following the expected rain. Rainfall further inland, though, to the west of the Divide, will be patchy and hit and miss. Totals will be much lower in general, and while some places along the slopes may see some welcome showers and storms, others in drought-affected areas may see very little at all. So, with weather set to impact much of the East Coast this weekend, make sure you stay up to date on our website, app and social media for all the latest forecasts and warnings, and please follow all advice from emergency services.